family matters. Imagine there is a family, a father, a mother, and three children, an 18-year-old daughter, a 16-year-old daughter, and a 6-year-old son. The father knows that the eldest daughter will be leaving home at the end of summer, which means this summer is the last ever opportunity for the family to have a summer holiday together. This is important to him, and he is willing to fund a really special holiday. He analyzes the situation. Where has the family already been, and where not? What activities do the family members enjoy or not? What is the available budget? After a thorough analysis, he decides on a holiday on the East Coast of America in August. He now needs to secure the support of his family members. Not everyone likes the idea. One would like to go to the East Coast, but not with the whole family. The second keeps her options open and does not adopt a position. The third does not want to go with the whole family, may be tempted by America, but not the East Coast. The fourth wants to go to Europe. So the father has a problem. How does he solve it? Option one, you consult with the family, and if they do not change their position, you put them under pressure. Does that help? Probably not. Option two, change the agenda and create a multi-issue game. A multi-issue game means one, widening your agenda. It is not just about the holiday. Two, asking the other players to come up with issues that matter to them in view of the wider agenda. These issues could be rules on going out, the chores rota, whether or not to have a pet, the summer holiday, the skiing holiday. Perhaps someone wants to pass their driving test, visit some famous museums. Each of the players must have a list of issues that are attractive. There must be something in it for them. There needs to be a perspective of gain. But the list can also include issues that the players actually strongly oppose. The youngest daughter would really like a great skiing holiday in Italy, but is completely against having a pet. So there is some potential gain and pain on the agenda.
This is the multi-issue game. The focus is no longer exclusively on the question of whether this family goes to America. That would be a single-issue game, an either-or game. A single-issue game provides a strong incentive for conflict. You are either for the holiday or against it. A multi-issue game provides an incentive for cooperation. A multi-issue game has five potential effects.
A multi-issue game is an incentive for the parties to sit down with each other, to begin a process of negotiation. If the father invites his eldest daughter to a family consultation with just a single issue on the agenda, there is a strong incentive for the daughter not to attend. Why should she? There's nothing in it for her. But with a multi-issue agenda, the situation is completely different. There's something in it for her. And if she refuses to engage in this process of negotiation, others will gain and she will not. And when you have entered into a process, it's not easy to use the exit option, to leave the process.
A multi-issue game provides an incentive for playing the game of give and take. As I said, a single-issue game is an either-or game. You are either in favor or against the issue, and this almost always leads to conflict. A multi-issue game creates much more room for maneuver. The game between the actors gains more space and flexibility.
A multi-issue game includes incentives for cooperation. What happens when the players in the multi-issue game have reached decisions? A multi-issue game creates changing coalitions. For each issue, there will be a different coalition of supporters and opponents. There is a decision about the pet. The father and mother are in favor, the children against. A decision about a skiing holiday, with father and his daughters in favor, and mother and son against. A decision on the rules about going out, with the father, eldest daughter and son in favor, and the mother and second daughter against. Changing coalitions create dependencies. When it comes to the pet, the father and his daughters disagree. But when it comes to the skiing holiday, they agree. If the daughters need their father's support to make the skiing holiday happen, they know that they will need to collaborate with their father when it comes to the pet.
In a single issue game, the players can of course also reach a decision. It will be a compromise, with little room for maneuver for players. Ultimately, there is only one issue on the agenda. None of the players get his or her way, and both parties can therefore be disappointed. In a multi-issue game, there are many more opportunities to reach a beneficial decision. Smart combinations of issues can also be made, as a result of which the ultimate compromise is more favorable. You can pass your driving test during the holiday or visit a famous museum and use the money that you save to spend on the skiing holiday.
Finally, a multi-issue game promotes learning. Because there are so many issues, a lot of combinations are possible. Some of these combinations will come as a surprise to participants in the multi-issue game. They only discover that these combinations are possible and attractive during the game itself. When these attractive combinations arise, this can result in players changing their preferences. Perhaps the father will give way on his preference for the East Coast during the process and learn that other combinations of issues are also attractive. A skiing holiday, including a day spent on cultural activities, for example. Multi-issue games promote learning processes.